Hi everyone, this is going to be a repair video, and this is my old trusty Korg M3 synthesizer. This is just the actual synth module. I've detached it from the keyboard. At the moment, it's got a problem with the touch screen. This is a touch screen. And in these packets here, I've purchased a couple of spare touch screens that we're going to replace this with. Now, this is a big job, so let's just show you what's wrong with it. And it's booting up. I forgot how long this thing takes to boot up. It takes ages. Okay, it's booted up and it just doesn't work at all. It's not even responsive, but it still works. Nothing wrong with the synth, but just not completely non-responsive touchscreen. Anyway, let's take it apart. So now we're going to need to remove the main board here, and to do that we need to get to the LCD module, which is underneath. But while we're having a look at this, there's a couple of things that we probably should just discuss, I think, because there's a couple of interesting things in this. Firstly is, notice how the mains connection here is actually connected to one of those standard sort of power supplies that you see a lot of synthesizers use, and what Korg have chosen to do is actually keep that internal. So that's interesting. That does increase quite considerably the weight of this module, and perhaps maybe, I don't know why they decided to make that as a design choice, but anyway, it was interesting. The other thing that you want to look at too when you're looking through these things is fuses. Make sure your fuses are okay. I've noticed here there's a memory slot which probably could use a bit of memory in, so if I want to increase the memory of this. There's a battery here. These tend to go, so I should check the voltage of that. Also, there's an SD card here, and I wouldn't be surprised if that SD card actually contains the firmware for this whole, it's like the main hard drive for this whole synthesizer. So I had a look at this before when off camera, but I'll just bring it out again for you guys. But it's a 1 gig SD card, okay? All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna disconnect, like I said, the main board. And to do that, we need to start removing these connectors here, this one, these, and this one for now. This one is already disconnected, so we don't need to remove that. Okay, and I believe these can be quite difficult to get off. So just come up, you bastard. I don't need to remove this one because it's only just connected to the board below. Next we need to do is we need to undo, there's three screws that we need to undo. So one, two, three. We're gonna have to remove these screws here on the back. Need to remove this one, these. As soon as I undid that screw, the whole main board started to move. So that main board's gonna come out now. I can feel it. And the last cable we need to remove is just this one here. Just push down on that and pull. So there's the main board gone. That is a synthesizer. This looks like my touchscreen in here. this is what we need to get into, this part. The LCD module is the next thing I need to take out. So I need to take these screws out here. One, two. So there's going to be quite a bit to take out here. That's going to be, I'm going to unplug this. I'm going to have to unscrew this. So yeah, I think there's going to be quite a bit we're going to have to take out, and all these screws along here as well. All right, let's get to it. Now you should be able to remove the LCD module by lifting one end, the bottom, which is this end, and carefully pulling it sideways. There we go. It kind of gets stuck on these little white, I don't know if you can see them here, these little white things here. Here and here and here. So that's how it comes out. Anyway, this is what we need to get to. So the rest of the repair, we're only just going to be working on this part. So let's get rid of the synth part. All right, there is our LCD module, front, and that's the back. So the next part is we're going to mark on here with some with a pen. So I'm going to be marking all along here with a texter so that I get the exact position, because this is all measured probably in a factory, right? And then what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be cutting. There's actually in here there's like double-sided foam tape, okay? So I need to cut that with a sharp knife. So we'll go grab the sharp knife, we'll get this disconnected, and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so to disconnect this disconnector module, you've got to pull out the little plastic here, and then this thing should just pull out like that. See that? That's disconnected now. That part's done. Now the next part is to draw. We're going to be drawing around this, okay, with a permanent marker. So this is a Sharpie. And I'm going to be drawing all the way around this. Done. And that will get our position. Now, this is the bit which you have to be careful, you don't want to cut yourself, but you need to use a really sharp knife. I'm using a craft knife. And we need to cut around the sticky foam, which is all around the edges here. And what we need to do is actually cut it just underneath the glass. So find the top of the glass and slide the knife in, and you can see the knife there, and you just want to cut along there like that. Done. That should just pull off now, and you can see the little bit of sticky foam that was left behind there. So we do not want to touch this screen here while we're doing this part of the job, okay? And then what we want to do is we want to get rid of all of this sticky foam. Thank you. we've now removed the old touch screen and the sticky foam. So now what we've got to do is we've got to replace that sticky foam with new double-sided sticky tape. So what we've got to be careful of is we've got to make sure that it doesn't touch the LCD screen at all. And the other thing too is when we put the new touch screen in, there's a right way up and a wrong way. So you can tell with this one which is the right way and which is the wrong, because it's got the sticky tape on it. But just so we know, it's the bit where the connector is on the top. That's the up part. So it goes down like that. So we'll leave this one here so that we've got something to guide ourselves by. All right, now we've got our 3mm tape, which is pretty close to the original, but this one's white. So let's see if this is any good. All right, so what I think I'll do is copy the exact same positioning. Because you can slide, I don't know if you can see on the camera, but there's still a little mark where it was. I don't want to start that off. That works. Tape for now. Now we need to wipe that. Absolutely nothing. On that screen at all. Pretty clean. So this is the new one. Remember, we're going to be putting it in that way. So that's got to go to the top. And we don't want to touch the bottom of the screen when we pull it out. All right, so let's keep it in the bag for now. And let's take off our double-sided tape. Okay, just the edge. God, I'm nervous. Okay, we've got our little marker there for the corner. See if this works. We're going to put it all back together. Turn this over. Connect that up. So that's connected. Alright, the next job is to grab the module that went back in here. Guys. let's give it a whirl. Okay, now we need to calibrate this, so we have to go into global. God, it's already working. Unbelievable. Okay, so we've got touch panel calibration there. Touch the two rectangles. One, two, done. Oh my God, it's working. That is so cool. Okay. Okay, we've got to calibrate the pads now. There we go. Pads. That's done. Feel that that screen needs a bit more of a calibration.